Sam here from Creative Minds. In this video, we're going to do a basic run through of the CM Downloads Manager plugin from Creative Minds, which is a file sharing and document repository tool for your WordPress site. It will create a customizable downloads page, it supports various file types, and there's also a download counter, along with modification, access control, and notification settings for your site's users. So let's check it out.
The index page includes the list of all of the files uploaded into the CM Download Manager. You can show the list in three suggested views: tiles, list, and category. Users can use the search bar to look for a particular download. And as you can see, the category names are at the top, and for each download, you can see the title, the author, and how many times it's been downloaded. You can also do some basic adjustments to the page look and feel. For example, there are some sidebar widgets that you can find and integrate using WordPress widgets. Under settings, if you go to index page settings, this is where you can control the appearance of that index page. You can choose the default download list view, whether it's tile, list, or category. You can also choose how to order the downloads by the latest notification time, the download name. You can also give a title to your downloads listing, a search placeholder. You can also choose to enable a description of the download on the list page and how many downloads you want on that index page. The download page conforms to your WordPress site's theme. You can customize how the page looks, including the labels for each download form. You can also create different tabs for your downloads page, and you can change the name of the tabs and add and remove them for easy navigation. Now let's check out the download page settings. Here you can control the appearance of that individual download page. You can choose to have the counter increase every time a page is refreshed. You can also include screenshots. These are kind of like a header image that appears on your download page. Below, you can also upload an image that is your default no screenshot image if you don't have a particular header for your download. You can also enable a slideshow of screenshots so you can have more than one. And there are various other appearance settings. If you go down to labels, here are tabs that appear on your download page, and each one of these tabs can have its own content. You can change the names of tabs and add and remove tabs for easy navigation. The CM Download Manager plugin comes with a built-in support forum for each download. To enable the support forum, you need to make sure that this is turned on in the plugin settings and also for each particular download page in order to enable the support tab. This forum can help users leave comments, and the download author can support those questions related to the download. And under the moderation settings, this is where you can auto-approve new questions or auto-approve new answers to that support forum. And here we have an example of a download page that has three different files, and they're all audio files. You can preview them, and as you can see, you can choose to download a zip file or individual files. This download page is an example of using a shortcode for that download. You can see over on the right that there are three different shortcode options. Your users can select one or more to then download. Under appearance and general settings, this is where you can control or enable all of those different panels and all of the different preview options for your downloads. Now, this is important. If you have an MP3 or audio file, you'll need to enable the player for downloads, and this allows a music player option to preview that particular music file. And you can also choose which kind of music player you want to use. We have Do Player, J Player, as well as Core Audio. And below, you'll need to enable file preview for downloads. Under the upload section in general settings, here the administrator can define which file extensions different users can upload. You can also choose which type of download should be available for uploaders, whether it's the file upload, a URL, or shortcode. An administrator can also decide whether an uploader needs to define a category for their upload. You can also choose the maximum number of categories that can be assigned to any one download. There's also a password protection option, so this means that the user is going to need to input a password to download that particular file. So let's delve more into categories. Here you can see a list of all of the categories that you have defined for different types of downloads. And if you want to add a category, you simply put in a name, choose if it has a parent category or not, give it a description, and add a new category. So when users are searching for a download or when they upload a download to the repository, they can assign one or more categories to each download. Now let's go ahead and add a download. This is what it's going to look like when a user goes to add a new download. You can give it a title as well as a version number. You're going to choose the download type, whether it's a file, a URL, or shortcode. And then you can go ahead and just simply select files. And the CM Downloads Manager plugin allows for multiple file uploads. And then below, you can choose whether or not the user can download single files. There's also the option to enable previews for that particular download. And you're going to need to assign a category. You can give your download a description and include installation instructions if you want to. Screenshots, here's where you can select a file that's sort of going to be the header of that download page, as we'll see in a minute. You can choose to password protect your download so that a user needs that password to be able to download that particular file. Some of the final options here, you can choose whether or not you want to be notified of any new support topics as the author of a particular download. And you can also require a non-logged in user to provide their name and password. So once you say add new, you can go ahead and view that download. So this is what the downloads page looks like. As you can see, we've got our header image at the top, and we've got our short description, and those multiple tabs with the support tab enabled. Here, users can start a new topic and add a question if they feel they need help using that particular download, or if they have any questions. Users can rate a download, and over on the right-hand side, we have the download info with the name of the author, the version, how many times the download has been viewed, the file size, the download counter, and the upload date. Now, because this particular download is password protected, the user is going to need to input that password before they can download. This is an example of when you have a non-logged in user provide their first and last name as well as email when they download. So here we have an MP3 audio example. So for this download, over on the right-hand side, you can see that there's a little audio player here, and that's because I've enabled the audio player for this particular download. So users can sample an audio file before downloading it. Here we have a PDF file preview example. If you have enabled the preview, over here on the right-hand side, above download, a user can simply click Show Preview, and it will open up in Google Docs a preview of that file download.
So as you can see, the CM Downloads Manager plugin creates a robust infrastructure for file sharing on your WordPress site. It's customizable and can be used in various scenarios, and I encourage all of you to check out this plugin from Creative Minds.